Hey everyone, welcome to TechWired. In this data science series, we are going to see about linear algebra. We're going to see the basics of linear algebra in this video, and we are going to focus on the concept that is required in the industry today. And we are only concentrating on to clear the interviews and get into the top companies. So first, we're going to see the fundamental things. First, the point. What's a point? We want to see how a point going to leverage as a vector. Okay, it's very interesting. First we will focus on the 2D. Why it's called 2D, we'll see. So this is 2D, right? Why it's 2D? We have two columns. How? Assume this is a point. Okay, this is a point, right? This is 5 and this is 6. Okay, this thing is connected, 5, 6, right? This is X and this is Y. This is a point. So how this can be written? Sorry, 5, 6, this is X, Y. So if you see, this is two columns. This is two columns and one row. This is one row and we have two columns. That is the reason why it's called two dimension, 2D. Right? Now, this can be, how this is going to be leveraged into 3D, we'll see that. In 3D, it's going to be like this, right? This X, this is Y, this is Z. Assume this is a point. Some point P2. 6, 5, 7. Okay? Just focus on these things. So now this can be written as 6, 5, 7, right? This is a 3D. Since we have three columns and one row, this is columns, this is a row. This is a 3D. A human can visualize only till 3D or 4D. But in real world, we are going to have n dimensions. So what we are going to do that? So that's the reason you are going to have a lot of columns and features in a data set. Have you seen, if you have seen a data set before, you can see that it's going to be F1, F2, like many features. So the columns also called as features, variables, dimensions. Okay, next we are going to focus on distance of a point from origin. So we have seen 2D, we know what is 2D now. This is x1. For simplicity, I'm going to make it x1. And this is x2, rather than y, we are going to make this one as x2. So what we said before, this is a 2D, since we have two columns, right? This is the origin. We are going to calculate the distance from origin to the point. Okay? Assume you have a point here. This is x1. Assume this is A1 or A2, okay? This is a point. This is A1 and this is A2. Okay? We need to calculate this distance. We need to calculate the distance D. We need to calculate the distance from a point from origin. Calculate this distance. How we are going to calculate this? We know this, the length is a1 here, the length is a2. We need to find the distance. Here comes a new concept called the Pythagoras theorem. Mind me with the spelling. Pythagoras theorem. So the distance d is equal to root a1 square plus a2 square. This is the formula for Pythagoras theorem in order to calculate a distance from the origin of a point. Okay, this one. Now we are going to extend this one to 3D space. How we are going to extend? We just saw here, right? How 2D can be changed to 3D, right here. Now we are going to see how a 2D distance of a point from origin can be extended to a 3D distance of a point from origin. See, this is x1, this is x2, this is x3, right? Assume I have a point here. This is a point. X1, x2, a1, a2, a3. Simple terms. Okay? Now I need to calculate from origin. This is origin. This is a 3D space. I'm going to make it clear here. This is a 3D space. Now, how we are going to make it? How we are going to calculate it? If you know how it should be calculated, please pause the video and just try it. Okay. So the distance is root, just an extension, a1 square, a2 square plus a3 square. This is the distance of a point from origin in a 3D space. Now, how we are going to make it to nd space for n dimensions? For n dimensions, we cannot visualize. How we are going to do it? So it's going to be like this: a1 square, a2 square, so on, an square. It's n dimension. N dimension. This is the distance formula of a point from origin for n dimension space. Right? So on distance between two points. Okay? No, not only two points, for n points. Okay? For n points. N points. First, we are just similar to the previous things. We are going to see it from a 2D perspective. This is x1, this is x2. Okay. Assume I have two points. Assume I have two points. This is A and this is B. Okay. This is A1, A2. This is B1, B2. We need to calculate this distance. Can you see? This is the distance. Okay. We're just making the notation here. This is A1, A2. Intersection points. I mean the point. So this is B1, B2. Okay. X and Y axis. X1 and X2 axis. So What is the distance formula? We know the distance formula, right? What is the distance here? We need to calculate this. Can you see this? We need to calculate this distance. First, this is b1 minus a1. This is b2 minus a2. Okay. Now, applying the distance formula here, it is going to be d is equal to the whole root of a1 b1 minus a1 square plus b2 minus a2 square. It's okay, you are not going to get a negative term here since you have square here. It's fine. Okay. Now, extending to in 3D space. This is 3D. This is X, this is Y, this is Z. Okay. Now extending this to 3D space. We all know this is X1, X2, X3. You have a point. How are you going to do it? It's going to be same. The distance is equal to, you're going to get extra point. B1 minus A1 square, A2 square plus A3 B3 square. It's going to be very similar to this. So for ND space, how it's going to be? It's going to be distance between the points, root, right? It's going to be summation, I is equal to 1 to n, b1, bn minus an square. This is what it's going to be look like. Another fundamental thing I just want to say you guys is, as we said, this is a two dimension, right? And if you go n, this is n dimension, as I said before. So it's going to be 1 cross n. It's one row and n columns, right? I just want to say this. This is called a row vector. A row vector is nothing but when you have a one row and n columns, is going to be a row vector. So for similarly, as you guys guessed, for a column vector, it's going to be like this. Going to be n rows and one column. This is called column vector. Okay. Also, I want to let you guys know that this is a scalar. One dimension is called a scalar. Okay. When you have the 2Ds are called or vectors. When you have two or more columns, two or more columns, then it is a vector. I just want to let you know, guys, this, because we are going to use the vector term most often in the next video, upcoming videos. So please like and subscribe and press the bell icon to get notifications once I upload the videos in this data science series. We are going to focus more on mathematical perspective on machine learning algorithms, which is going to be very helpful for you people in clearing the top company interviews. So keep supporting and happy learning. Cheers.